I just wonder if you get tired of being outrageous.
I don't think I'm outrageous at all.
Are you there, David Bowie?
Yes.
Last time we met on the air, you were sitting in this studio at this side, and you had a very elegant earring hanging from either your left or right ear. I can't remember. Do you remember that?
How are you, Russell? It's nice to see you.
But I'm very happy to present to you this golden record for your tremendous LP, Low. Well, let's take it this way.
I want to look at it.
Well, you want to look at it. All right, take it.
Well, don't ask me that question. I cannot believe you asked me that question.
No? Why not?
Do you believe you actually asked me that question?
Well,
you're keeping something.
I've answered the question.
Right, okay.
You were really the point man for challenging a lot of social attitudes and sexual attitudes in the 70s.
Oh, rubbish.
Now, you've just finished making the film called The Man Who Came to Earth.
Fell to Earth.
Fell to Earth, I beg your pardon.
Critics have claimed that you are more ideas.
You are the bossy egomaniac.
If you describe yourself as ordinary, what adjective would you use?
David Bowie.
Oh, ideas.
We're talking about films and filmmaking. One of the people I presume you would have liked to have worked with would have been Piero Pasolini.
Would I?
Well, look, there's a million things I could ask you, and I can't go on.
Well,
before there's one question, David. Don't you dare with it anymore.
You know, also, since you've been away, or quite recently, the newspapers have been having a bit of a bash at your mother, and saying that she's a bit tearful from time to time, and that she's suffering a certain amount of anguish, and that she doesn't hear from you an awful lot. Is that eyewash, or is it real?
That's really my own business.
And that's how it's going to stay, is it?
Yes.
Well, I'm reluctant to make the judgment about what category you fit into, and I'm hoping that you would say, yes. Oh, no, I wouldn't be that pretentious, but maybe you have a feeling yourself.
That in the 60s you felt that bands had a really immediate feel. Mm. Do you think that you've managed to recreate that?
No.
Okay, now, what I wanted to say, as soon as you're outside of the protected
area...
Yeah,
I got the question.
You're right.
No. No.
Do you know that the pop scene at this end, the pop world has changed somewhat since you left?
No. No.
Have you heard of the Bay City Rollers?
Yes.
Well, you know that they are appealing to a kind of large, mass hysterical audience of young people who wave a lot of stuff around. Now, I wonder what kind of audience you're going to come back to face.
I don't know. What do you think?
I don't know. I'm thinking in a kind of way. You may have to create a whole new scene for yourself.
No.
Do you want to be understood? You know what I mean? That Ziggy Stardust was
nothing to understand. I mean,
was concerned with famine in the world and so on, and prophecies of the world running out of...
For someone who claims not to be all that good a musician, why are you coming back to perform on stage? Or are you a better musician, in fact, than you admit?
I can't link those two parts. If I'm not that good a musician, why am I coming back?
Yes. Yes.
Does this make you nervous to sit without your band and with everything and just to chat a little bit?
Let's carry on talking. Don't ask me that.
What colour is your hair?
Which bit?
The centre bit at the top, above where your nose would be.
Well, it's... What colour does it look?
Well, it looks like a bit of something out of the end of Straw Dogs.
Something out of the end of Straw Dogs.
But he and she's you've loved in your time, haven't you?
So I've read.
I've only heard two, but it was you've been asked the question whether you're bisexual or not.
Too many times.
Yes, and you've never quite answered it.
Oh, I have. I said I was bisexual, that's enough.
Mm.
You said you don't feel yourself a hero.
No.
People make you a hero.
No, they don't.
For them.
No, they don't. You don't make me a hero. I know I'm not a hero.
What is the power of still going on?
It isn't.
Doing it. Doing...
Nope.
Making records, selling.
Yeah. That's work.
Just work.
Yeah.
What are you looking for at this moment? What are you searching for?
Got
liquid.
It.
Liquid.
Tree top apple juice.
Is it good? Would you spit some across the satellite?
No.
You're keeping something.
I've answered the question.
Right, okay.
Bits and pieces I used to do many years ago, like painting, writing, spending free time with myself and my family. Getting out of cities.
And relaxing a lot.
No, not relaxing.
No.
No. No. That's really my own business. No.
Is there a leader in your group?
Yes, quite definitely.
Oh.
I am the leader.
Are you? You are the bossy egomaniac.
I mean, you're equipped with fame. You're equipped with a certain amount of fortune. You're equipped with, I presume, with the kind of advisors who will give you good advice. And therefore, you're not like a girl or a boy sitting in a basement in Notting Hill struggling to get into some kind of proper situation, who wants to be an actor, who wants to be a film star, who wants to get onto the scene.
I was, though.
Oh, I don't know where you read that, but that's not true. No, but that's not true.
I don't think I would like to get into that over a 20-minute interview.
You wouldn't?
When I come back to England, I would talk to you about that, yes.
Right.
At length.
How calculated is any of this? That's bollocks. Bollocks.
I can...
Oh, well, it doesn't have to be that one-sided, does it?
Well...
Aren't you going to contribute?
A little bit, yes. I'm worming away by expensive satellite.
No, okay.
Very excited that you're here this evening. Marvellous band, a marvellous new album that we're going to be hearing.
I had a good night's viewing plan, so we run a bit late, so let's get this done.
Okay.
Well, David, we're coming towards the end of our all-too-brief conversation.
Oh, that's a shame.
I think that's going to be enough, because I can't go on. I just can't go on badly.
Okay, I'm gonna have to pick some easier songs. I'm never gonna get through half of these. Let's try Fame.
Bollocks.